Mao Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutane Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarvasudeva Gauravani Prachane Girvesesa Sonyavadi Patadadadane Hare Krishna. So I was asked to speak on the Archana relationship with the Holy Name. Yes, we all know that nectar devotion, the five most potent activities in devotional service are Achanam, worship, the deities, chanting the holy name, hearing the Shrimad Bhagavatam, Sadhu Sangha, yes. So when we do Parikrama, we have the opportunity to do all those things at once. And when you think about Archana is very, very important because it is the relationship between us devotees and Krishna. Although Krishna is staying in Goloka Vrindavan, we are in this material world, but through the mechanism of deity worship, we can get into contact with Krishna. It is said somewhere in the Srimad Bhagavatam, third canto, that the deities in the temple are not different from Krishna in Goloka Vrindavan. So now, depending on how we see them, if you see them as ordinary wood or iron or stone, well, they will remain like that. But Archanam is very important, and Prithu Maharaj is the acharya in this field. So in deity worship, there are many, many, many attempts, like more than 64 attempts. But in any action in the deity worship, there is always mantra. Mantras, mudras, many things. You cannot do worship without doing any mantra or any mudra. But the mantra of the mantra, we all know, is the Mahamantra. Supposing you want to worship Krishna and you don't know all the mantras and all the mudras, but you have your mouth, to take on Krishna. Just like the Brahman who was in South India, was reading Bhagavad Gita, and the Bhagavad Gita was in the opposite side, but he was reading and it was tearing, was crying. So everybody was laughing at him because very stupid. How can you pretend to read a book and the book is not in the right position? So he said, people were making fun of him. So when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to him, he said, why are you crying? He said, well, when I look at this, Krishna, you know, has become the Parthasarthi, the chariot of Arjuna, Krishna is God. How can he become a chariot conductor of his devotee? So when I look at it, it makes me cry. So actually everything depends on sentiment. You may know the mantra, you may know the sloka, you may know the mudra, or the yantras, but is it followed by the proper attitude or the proper sentiment? That's why in every worship that we do, we always conclude with the Mahamantra. The Mahamantra is the final conclusion of everything. Because Antakalitama Meva, Krishna said, at the time of death, anyone who remembers me alone, not with another person, he alone, will attain my nature. Then we have to train ourselves. Actually, everything that we do in ISKCON, deity worship, Harinam, book distribution, everything we do is to train our mind to love chanting the Mahamantra, because that is the final exam. The final exam is to remember Krishna. If you remember Krishna at the time of leaving the body, then you become qualified. to enter. But it is start with actually getting to touch, in touch with Krishna by deity worship. So deity worship, and during the Parikrama, we have a lot of opportunities to see many original deities that we cannot see when we are in America or in Africa or Europe. So this Parikram gives us the opportunity to do the Archanam, to chant the holy name, to have a Sadhu Sangha, to hear Shrimad Bhagavatam. Everything that we are supposed to do, we do that in Parikram. So Parikram gives us this opportunity to I always say that when I come to the dam, is to recharge our batteries. Our batteries are low battery, 10%, 5%. But when we come in the dam, we have to recharge them. Generally, when we wake up in the morning, our first reflex is to check our mobile phone. What is the percentage? If it is 20, it's, oh, not good. Then charge it. When we charge it, we wait till it becomes 100%. Even if it is 99%, we are not happy. We want 100%. So we are supposed to charge our batteries to the level of 100%. But now, when we go back, we are going to do many activities that are going to, again, bring our battery down. And again, next year, we come in, we recharge our battery. So Archana is very important because by worshipping Krishna, I thought it is the main thing we should to do. Because in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, Sarva dharma paritam tarchaga, mamitam sarvana vraja. All the worship, abandon them, all religion, abandon them, and only worship me. Sometimes when we are in the West, in Africa, people ask us, this verse doesn't mean that I should not be Christian, or Muslim, or Hindu. What does it mean? Abandon all religion. Because Christianism is a religion. Islam is a religion. Hinduism is a religion. So if you abandon all these things, then what's the point? The point is that whatever we do, that we don't come to the level of worship, the conclusion of worshipping Krishna is zero. That one verse, I forgot it in the Shrimad Bhagavatam, it says that any activities we do that does not lead us to welfare activity, any welfare activity that doesn't lead us to renunciation, any renunciation that we do that doesn't lead us to devotion service, it is that person is considered dead even though he's breathing. Understand? So whatever we are doing in this world, if the conclusion is not to please Krishna, it means our life is like we are in the Shrimad Bhagavatam, they are called Nara Pashu. Animals with two legs. So we should not be animal with two legs, we should be animal, real human beings, because real human life starts with devotional service. So the Prabhupada mentioned that before we worship Krishna, at least we should become human being, normal human being. That's why the process of Krishna consciousness first starts with the four regulative principles. By following this principle, we become normal human being. When you become a normal human being, then you can think of worshipping Krishna. So deity worship in the temple is not just idol worship. This is another thing we are being accused in the West, that you guys are worshipping idol. It is mentioned in the scripture that you should not worship any other thing except God. But we say, suppose you meet Krishna God face to face and carve a form of that God you see face to face. It is not idol worship. Yeah. In the Kali Yuga, it is mentioned that Krishna will appear as a wood. This is a Jagannath. He will appear as water. This is Ganga. So this worship is not just an idol thing. It's not to play. It's very serious. It's a connection with Krishna. I will conclude with, by saying that Srila Prabhupada gave an analogy in the Nectar of Instruction, Ishvanshad. He said, if you have a letter, not like nowadays we have email, we have WhatsApp, no. In the old days, just write your letter, give it to the postman, if you put it in the post office. So Srila Prabhupada said that you cannot just write a letter and put it down on the streets and expect that your letter will get to the right destination. No. Give it to the right person, and then the right person will put it to the right place and your letter will be delivered. But if you write your letter and put it in the street, well, it's another way of sending letters, but it will not go anywhere. The person will not receive the letter. So by channeling our messages, our intention, our feeling through the spiritual master, to the deities, then our message will reach to Krishna. And again, we should not think that the deities in the temple are material. Krishna said, anybody who thinks that the deities in the temple is material is just a canister, is a neophyte. A neophyte cannot attend Rama Bhakti. So deity worship is very, very important. We have to train our mind because the mind has been worshipping so many nonsenses. When we wake up in the morning, we worship our car, worship our mobile phone, worship our wife, our children, our sandals. But we have to stop all this kind of rubbish and worship the supreme personality of God. That worship will take us back to Goloka Vrindavan. Because any other worship will not give us, take us to the right destination. So archana is very important to worship Krishna, and any deity worship, we must always chant mantras. And the mantra of the mantra, the Maha Mantra, is what? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.